More Than Words, a radio play by Katie M. Dean. Episode 4.
Leave me alone.
Lucas? Lucas, I know you're in there. Open the door.
Sophie, turn off the lights.
Morning, sunshine. Or should I say afternoon?
Go away.
Don't be such a baby. Oh my God, have you forgotten how to clean? This place is filthy.
How'd you get in?
You gave me a spare key when you moved, remember?
And now I remember why that was a bad idea. What do you want?
I want you to get up. I want you to eat. I want you to take a shower because it's 2 weeks and you stink. And I want you to call Mom and Dad back.
Why? They made it pretty clear they don't have anything to say to me.
They miss you.
Then they should have called.
They have called. You just haven't answered your phone.
I unplugged it.
What? Why?
I have nothing to say to them.
So that was your plan? That you just unplug from the world and live the rest of your life as a hermit? What happened to Joey? In Boston?
It didn't work out.
Why? What happened?
Nothing. I...
Lucas?
It was never going to work out anyways.
Why not?
Because... I don't know. He lives in Boston and I live here.
That's your excuse. Geography?
I'm not making excuses. Do you have any idea how difficult this is for me? To have the closest people in my life hate me overnight?
Mom and Dad don't hate you.
Okay, but what about everyone else? My friends? My coworkers? Amanda? The way they look at me now.
How do they look at you? Lucas, you can talk to me. It's me.
It's like I'm defective or something.
It makes you sound like a broken toy.
You know what I mean. Different. Strange. Flawed.
You're not flawed.
How do you know? That's what the Bible says. And the people in church.
Who are the people in church? What I meant was, this is who you are, and don't let anyone tell you otherwise.
What if I don't want to be like this? What if I want to be like you? What if I want to get married and have children?
Then you get married and have children!
It's not that simple.
It could be!
No, it's not. I can't do that.
Says who?
Everyone!
Not me! Lucas, the only person holding you back is you. Yeah, society might have their opinions, but that is all they are. Opinions. You have convinced yourself that society hates you so much that you have locked yourself away. You have to get over this giant, impossible wall that you've built for yourself and get out. Take a risk.
I did take a risk, and look how that turned out.
Mom and Dad just needed some time.
Okay, but what about Amanda? I really hurt her.
So apologize.
I have.
Then that's all you can do. It's up to her to get over it.
But what about Mom and Dad? It's as if they don't know how to talk to me anymore.
Did they ever know how to talk to you? Mom and Dad still love you.
Doesn't seem like it.
It just came as a shock, that's all. Not to me, of course. I always knew you were defective. Oh, come on. Laugh a little. It's not like somebody died.
My hopes and dreams.
This is who you are, Lucas. And it's the first time in a long time that I've recognized my big brother.
Really?
Really. And you need to be who you are. Even if you were striped like a zebra, I would still love you.
Striped like a zebra?
Shut up. I'm trying to make a point.
Parenting has made you weird.
Don't change the subject.
I'm sorry. You were saying?
You told us that Joey is the first person who made you feel...
like myself.
Yeah. So you should be with him.
Thank you.
You did the right thing.
Did I?
Yes. You need to take care of yourself. Everyone else will come around.
How are you doing?
I'm good.
And my niece?
She's good too.
Sleeping? Eating?
Pooping. All of the things that babies do.
Good. Good.
I should probably get back to her. And you should come over and see her.
I will.
Good. And you should call Mom and Dad.
Right.
What's this package by the door? The return address says Boston.
I don't know.
Well, I'll see you later, okay?
Okay. Joey sent me a scarf?
Dear Lucas, I haven't heard from you in a couple of weeks. I'm sorry I pushed you. It wasn't right to assume that's what you wanted. Everyone moves at their own pace. I was sure of who I was when I was young, but some people take a little longer. And some people never get there. I pray you become confident in who you are and who you're meant to be. And maybe I no longer have a place in this story. But if I helped you figure out your place in this story, then that's enough. Be well, Lucas. Love, Joey.
It's open. Oh, it's not a good time.
I just brought over your reports from work. Things are really starting to pile up.
You sound like Joey.
What?
Nothing. I can take those. Thanks, Amanda.
Yeah.
This is a box of your stuff. I was going to mail it, but since you're here, it's just t-shirts and shampoo and other things.
Thank you. I'll just mail your box.
Okay.
You look good, Lucas.
You too.
Your apartment could use some work, though.
So I've been told.
Is that a message from Joey?
Probably. It's definitely not something for work.
Is that a picture of him next to your computer?
Yeah.
He needs better taste in clothes.
I've told him that.
I haven't told anybody, you know.
Oh, okay.
I just told people that we had different interests.
That's an understatement.
And I explained that you have the flu. That's why you haven't been to work.
Okay.
That's it?
What?
No, thank you, Amanda, for keeping my dirty little secret.
Thank you.
It's not easy, you know, dodging all of their questions.
I'm sorry.
But they are starting to get suspicious about why you've been gone so long.
I thought you told them I have the flu.
I did, but someone can only have the flu for so long.
Well, I'll be gone soon, so it won't matter.
So you're actually going? To Boston?
I'm actually going.
How are your parents?
Adjusting.
How's your sister and the baby?
Good.
They're healthy?
Yes, I was actually getting ready to go to my parents before you walked in.
Then I should probably go.
I truly am sorry, Amanda, for what I did.
Lucas.
I know you don't want to hear it anymore, but I am. I'm sorry for the way I treated you. You're a good person. You deserve better.
Just tell your mom I said hi.
Stop pacing and sit down. Lucas should be here soon.
Hi.
I made coffee.
Thank you. This is good coffee.
Very good coffee. Dad, don't you think it's good coffee?
Sure.
So how's Joey?
Yes, how's your friend?
Joey is good. Here, I even brought a picture of him.
Oh, that's an interesting scarf.
His grandmother made it for him.
It's nice. How's the packing going?
Good.
So, you've decided to leave then?
Yes. I know this is not what you wanted.
What?
Me.
Lucas.
But this is who I am. And this is what I want.
Lucas.
And Joey is a good person. He's just simply lacking a few things you deem essential in a relationship.
Lucas.
I need to at least meet him, Mom. And it can't be here. There's no life for me here anymore.
No, that's not true.
I need to be somewhere where nobody knows me. Where nobody knows who I used to be. What I used to be like. I need to be somewhere where people look at me as though I'm important.
You're important to us.
Mom.
Just let me talk. You shall not lie with a man as with a woman. Now, that's in the Bible.
Don't quote the Bible at us, Mom. Not now.
You shall not lie with a man as with a woman. That's in the Bible. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind, and with all your strength. Now, that's in the Bible too. And I've done that. I've loved the Lord with all my heart and soul. But I haven't loved my son.
Mom?
The second is this. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. God tells us the greatest commandment is love. To love unconditionally, no matter what. Lucas, I remember the day you were born. You were so tiny and weak. You could barely wrap your hand around my finger. And I just prayed. I prayed that you would grow up to be strong and brave. I prayed that you would have a long, full, happy life. And I prayed that I would be the mama you needed in every moment of your life. Every one. Well, I failed. I'm so sorry, Lucas. You are everything I prayed for. You're strong. You're brave. And now you're finally happy. And I'm so sorry.
You didn't fail, Mom.
I love you so much.
I love you too.
Can you forgive me?
Of course I can forgive you. Dad?
I love you, son. I'll always love you. But I can't accept this. I won't.
Okay, I've got my clothes, and my shoes, and my kitchenware. Don't know why I need that since I'll be living with Joey, but whatever.
How's it going?
I'm all packed, and my family should be here soon to drive me to the airport.
I'm sorry to hear about your dad.
Thanks, Joe.
How have you been handling it this past week?
Adjusting.
At least you still have your mom and your sister.
Yeah.
You okay?
I just keep replaying the conversation in my head. I feel like I could have explained it better, said different things, given my dad more time.
It sounds like you gave your dad plenty of time.
But I just feel like I've disappointed him. He always pushed me to do my best. Get straight A's, go to college, marry a girl like my mother, be the man of the house. Now, no matter what I'll do, I'll always be a disappointment.
But aren't you glad you told them?
Honestly, I'm not sure.
At least now you can finally be yourself.
It just doesn't feel that straightforward.
Nothing ever does.
How did you handle it?
When I told my parents?
Yeah, we never really talked about the details before.
Well, I told them when I was 12, but I think my parents always knew. At least my mom did. When I was little, I would sneak into my mom's closet and walk around in her high heels. She caught me a couple of times, but rather than yelling at me, she would help me match them with skirts and blouses. My mom would even ask for my fashion opinions. I don't know why, but my parents always supported who I was. I'm sorry you didn't have that. Nobody deserves to go without a family. Anyways, how did you know?
Well, I was in a lot of sports in high school, which I loved. But when we all went back to the locker room, I never quite engaged in the conversation. They would joke about girls, and of course I went along with it, but I never fully understood it. I realized that I didn't look at the girls the same way they did. And when prom came around, I was more interested in the quarterback than the cheerleader. And during college, I wanted to ask a guy to the homecoming dance. And then when my sister got married a couple of years ago, I couldn't stop staring at my brother-in-law. When it got to that point, I was so freaked out that I convinced myself that there was something wrong with me.
Why?
Everyone around me condemned it.
But what does your brother-in-law have to do with it?
Well, when I realized I was far more starstruck by my brother-in-law than the maid of honor, I was disgusted at myself. I mean, who has a crush on their brother-in-law? And what's worse is, I think my sister noticed. And then I had to convince her that I was just imagining their future and all that. Ugh, it was humiliating. And I so convinced myself that it would never happen again.
So what made you go online?
I needed someone to talk to. And talking to you was the first time I felt like myself in a long, long time.
Wow. Really?
With you, I finally realized that this is who I am. I used to think I could convince myself otherwise, that I could change. But now, I know I was born this way, and nobody deserves to go through what I went through. I don't know what I would do without you, Joey.
I don't know what I would do without you, either.
Well, my family's here to take me to the airport. I'll see you soon, okay?
I'm Joey.
Lucas.
Welcome to Boston, Lucas.
Lucas, voiced by Braden Ingersoll. Joey, voiced by Michael Zaliski. Amanda, voiced by Audrey Kaus. Sophie, voiced by Eden Athena Mode. Mom, voiced by Maria Kosovich. Dad, voiced by Dallas Williams. Music by Kevin MacLeod.